Well, hello there, everybody, and welcome back to the channel, or indeed welcome to the channel if you're one of the new subscribers or a new viewer who's just about to subscribe by clicking on that red button. Yeah, that was a hint, by the way. So today we're continuing our guide to international management. Check out the playlist if you haven't seen the previous episodes in which we discussed why you should try out international management in FM21 and what improvements I would like to see to the international game in future versions of Football Manager. I've also made a video on six nations to manage in Football Manager 2021 that you might want to check out as well. But today we're going to be looking at how to set up your game for an international management career, and particularly we're going to be thinking about how to set up a game if you want to manage a minnow nation or a nation that doesn't have an active league in the game. Please note here, I am making this on the beta version rather than the full release, so I don't have any add-on leagues or any add-on competitions here. I will be making a video about those and how you can use them to enhance the international management game further down the line once the Steam Workshop started to fill up a bit. But today we're going to be looking at three key features for your game for international management with those minnow nations in mind, and those are the database setup, secondly the leagues to load, and finally your manager profile. And as ever, if you have any comments, ideas or suggestions of your own about international management and setting it all up, please do drop those down in the comments and leave a like on the video while you're down there. But we're gonna start out with database options. Now here we are in the familiar game setup screen. Now of course you can just select international manager from here, but we're gonna go into a little bit more detail than that. You will notice when you look at this, some nations are not here. Andorra is not here in Europe, for example. In Africa, they don't have every country represented. Places like Madagascar, for example, is not here on the list. This is because in your usual starting database, there simply aren't enough players in there to make a national team viable to fill the national pool. The only way to work around that is to get those add-on leagues that I mentioned, but as I said, those aren't available yet. We're going to be looking at those in a future video. For the purposes of this video, we're going to look at setting something up for Congo to be the international manager there, but a lot of what I'm going to say you can apply to other countries as well. So we're going to click on the advanced setup here. Now, as I'm sure you're aware, when you get to this screen, you will have some default suggested leagues or the leagues you most recently tried to load pop up. And you will have a database option here, small, medium, large. What we're going to do though is go for the advanced database. So when you click on that, again, you've got these database options. We're going to go for large. You always want to go for large just to get as many players as possible. And you see here, we've got here continents, regions, nations, divisions. Now, if we take a look at nations, we're already on Africa. So we select Congo, which is the team we want to manage. And you see we've got some options here. You're going to want to tick the first three. Current international players, players based in nation, players of nationality. So this basically means any player that's currently connected to the Congo squad, people who played in it in recent years, or who have a few caps, maybe if they haven't played for Congo for a few years, or youngsters who are eligible for Congo, they will all be loaded into the game and they will form the basis of your national pool. Players based in nation, so even though Congo does not exist within Football Manager as a playable league, there are players in the database who are attached to Congolese clubs, so they will be loaded in as well. And then another key one, players of nationality. So the difference between that and players based in nation is basically any Congolese players, no matter where they play their football in the world, if they're in South Africa, if they're in Europe somewhere, if they're in America, wherever they play, they will be loaded into the game as well. Now you can see here, if I deselect all of those options, 30,560 players in the game. Obviously the leagues we haven't looked at yet. If we tick them all up, it goes to up to 3,680. So not a massive increase, but it does give a lot more players that we can then potentially call upon. You could add in other nations as well if you were planning to have a bit of a journeyman. You could do regions as well, so that would be for Central Africa, Western Africa. We could add those in too. And you get the same options here. Current international players, players based in nation, players of nationality. So we add those all in. I like to do this sometimes just to have a bit more of a competitiveness to my careers. If the neighbouring nations don't have these options loaded, their squads will be filled with great players and it will be easy wins for you. You could even do this on a continental level, so in theory you could load all the international players and players of nationality for every continent in the world. Just if you do that, the player count will go through the roof and you'll get a warning from Football Manager telling you you've got too many players loaded. But by setting up this custom advanced database, this is a way to make sure your national pool is as full as possible when the game starts. However, to keep it that way, we're going to need some leagues active, and that's what we're looking at next. Now, if you're going for one of the big nations for your international career, this isn't so much of an issue. Even if you were to just load the standard leagues in Europe, you would still get enough players generated from places like Argentina and Brazil to make managing one of those national teams viable. For smaller nations, however, loading the right leagues is key. Otherwise, you will find your national pool shrinking and shrinking year on year as players retire. And I don't just mean retiring when they get to their mid or late 30s and decide to hang up their boots for good. You will also find the frustration of a player who performs well for your national team getting released by their club, being unable to find a new club, and then deciding to call it a day at the tender age of 23. Now, the first part of this point may seem a bit unnecessary, as it is rather obvious, but as someone who's worked in education for the last 20 years, I know sometimes the most obvious things need to be said. Yes, you do need to answer all of the questions and make sure you check the back page of the booklet as well. No, you can't look at your textbook during the test. Okay, what does it say there? After word limit, 1,000 words. Wait, does it say 1,000 words? Okay, then that's how many words you need to write. So, if the nation you want to manage has a league available in the game, load that league. So, if you want to manage Canada, load Canada. If you want to manage Malaysia, load Malaysia. It's pretty simple, really. Okay, so far so obvious, but what about those nations whose leagues are not available in the game? And remember, that video about add-on leagues is coming in the future. Well, here you're going to need to apply your knowledge of world football, your knowledge of geography, and your knowledge of history as well. So, taking a nation like Congo, if you know your history and the troubled colonial history of Africa, you would know that both Belgium and France were active in that region. So it would be a good idea to load those particular leagues. You will find a lot of players with dual nationality who already play in those leagues. You'll find new gens, regens coming through in those leagues who have Congolese nationality in addition to Belgian or French. Also, there will be players generated at the Congolese clubs in the game, even though the league's not active, and if they do move on from those clubs, France and Belgium are going to be their most likely destinations. Now, your knowledge of geography will also come into play, basically by thinking about which nations closest to that nation do have an active league in the game. So, of course, in this case, for any African team, that would be South Africa. And finally, your extensive football knowledge, or at least what a quick search on Wikipedia will tell you, this comes into play as well. As you will then discover that in addition to France and Belgium, Congolese players appear at clubs in the Swedish league. You've also got current Congolese internationals in Turkey, in Germany, in China, and we've even got the goalkeeper Christopher Mfubi at Morecambe in England. So the same applies elsewhere in the world. If you want to manage a Caribbean nation, for example, then you're going to want to look at loading the USA, Canada, maybe Mexico, maybe Colombia as nearby leagues. It will also be worth looking into whether that Caribbean island used to be part of the colonial territories of France, of Britain, of Holland, or of Spain, and loading up those leagues as well. And finally, as I said, do a bit of research online, find out who their current internationals are and where they play their football, and get all those leagues loaded up as well. And one final point about the leagues you load, always load them down to the lowest available level. When you're managing a small nation, It doesn't matter if those players are at Chelsea or Chorley, you're going to want all of them. And finally, we come to a sometimes overlooked part of the setup when you become an international manager, and that's the manager profile. Now, I'm not 100% sure if this has an effect, but you might want to consider your nationality. You might want to consider setting your nationality to the nation you're going to manage, or maybe your second nationality. Just because there's often that question when you take over an international manager job in the press conference, do you think a manager from a different country can ever successfully lead this team? Well, if you've got that nationality, maybe you'll just get a bit more respect from the players and the media. Now, of course, you could set your nationality to one of the big nations in the world. You could max out your coaching badges and your past playing experience and just shock and awe them into respecting you. But ultimately, of course, the coaching badge, the level of experience is up to you as the player. But it's worth thinking about these attributes down here. So I've gone with the suggested badges based on the Congo job, which would be a Continental B license and a professional footballer at a local level. But what I want to look at now are the attributes. Now, considering that you are an international manager and what international management in the Football Manager is like, there are certain things that are more important than others here. For example, working with youngsters and youngster knowledge. Probably not so important when you're not managing a club, unless of course you're thinking of managing an international under 21 or under 19 team. Likewise, things like goalkeeper skills, attacking, defending, all of these training things, they're probably not so important because, as we all know, training for some reason is not part of the international management experience yet. So considering that you will be working with a group of players from different clubs and possibly gathered from far-flung corners of this great earth, you should consider looking more at the mental side of coaching and upping your stats, like man management and motivation, maybe throw in a bit of discipline as well. So a setup focusing on those areas will help perhaps deal with those unruly players who moan when they don't get picked for a squad even though they're only just about recovered from an injury, or it'll help with persuading and motivating those dual nationality players to take up the cause and play for your team. Tactical knowledge, I think, is another area that you're going to want to look at maxing out, because of course you're just going to have a limited time to get players to get used to and work with your tactics. Probably a good idea to look at the mental and technical side of things here as well, to really get your players appreciating the finer arts of your tactical style. But overall, you're probably going to want to shift the balance more over to the mental attributes side, just to focus on getting that squad of players to gel together. So here we are, in game, ready to manage the great nation of Congo. Now, if you would seriously like to see me do that, let me know down in the comments. So we've got staff to hire, we've got a national pool to go through with a fine-tooth comb and fill up, and we've got competitions to win and expectations to meet. We've got dual nationality players to seek out and persuade to play for us. But those are all topics for future videos in the series. For now, thank you very much for watching this, the latest installment in my guide to international management. Do let me know if there's anything you found particularly useful or something obvious you think I've overlooked. But for now, enjoy managing your minnows. Don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so already. I'm Dodgy Gamer, and I'll see you again soon.